That's when my poker face left, bro. Because me and her, like, we looking at houses because we figured we finally can make this move. We looking at houses, and dude, this Israeli dude, I think, he showed us this house that was busted. The ceiling was falling in the bedroom. He's like, yeah, you can fix that. I'm like, well, no. Next victim. So the wife says, man, he showed us another house. She said, this would be nice, but it needs a basement. He said, basement? Like, let me show you a house with a basement. Now, for me, I wanted to stay south of Olympic because I can afford over here. North of Olympic, I can't afford none of this. Plus, they don't like my kind over here. So we had another couple with us, guy that was evaluating the house. And me and the wife and this dude, he keeps driving north. And he pulls us in the driveway. And I'm like, I ain't going in. So, because, I mean, it was like, it was over 200 G's. And that's a lot of money for me. That's still a lot of money to me. So we mess around and checked out the house, man. And fell in love immediately. But then I walked in that basement, man. I'm like, oh. I mean, I'm doing all this. Like, I walked in the basement like, give me. He looked at me, man. He's like, yeah, got this, dude. When we first got there, you remember this old show called The Munsters? Remember Grandpa Munster's basement? That's what it was. Toe up, dusty. Man, we moved in that mug. I put some boxes down there and locked the door. I ain't go down that mug for 6 months. It had flooded, so we didn't notice it in the excitement before we bought the house. The water was like this deep in that place. It was like, and it had these two humongous things called gravity heaters in them. It's like a big trash can, fire in the bottom, big tubes that go out like this. So basically the heat just uses gravity. Nothing but a fire in the bottom. Huge, asbestos, all the rest of that stuff. It took up probably a quarter of the basement. Yeah, so we had the water heater down there. It was a mess. It was toe up. So over the years, man, we just try to do one thing to the property every year. And 1 year was building a bar. Next year was doing the walls. The next year is getting electrical done, painting, you know. We've been there for, 30 years now. Thank you. And so basically, you know, my plan was to turn the whole thing into a studio. But then I got hold of that little nook over there in the corner. Perfect, man. Sounds good, man. So blessed to have that, man. I used to do, like, after the band broke up, man, it was like, I still can write. I still can play. So I had guys coming over. I had a drum machine, all the rest of that stuff. I would put two tape decks together. And swear to God. Then I got myself a 4-track, and I was like, oh, man. Then I realized I only got 4 tracks, you know what I'm saying? So it was like, it was a hot mess, man. So, but then from there, I went to ADATS, which was 8-track on it looked like a VCR tape. So I went from there, and then I got, you could chain those together. Highly unpredictable, though. They would do crazy shit. So, you know, and then the digital thing came in. So I was like hanging on to the tape thing for a minute because I was not making much money because we was having kids and stuff at that point. So at that point, man, it's like, once I got the digital thing going, you know, I was able to capture everything. And you know, I got Murderers Row, man, as far as the squad around me, man. These cats, man, are just stupid nice. So I was filling some spots around town. I hooked up with Taurus first. And we were playing in a band, Afro-Cuban band. Yep, killing. Big band. That's the biggest band I had been in since Pyramid. 3 horns, 2 percussionists, huge band. Anyway, so we did that. Then he introduced me to Wolf. And one night we were down there jamming with their project. And Saint comes in and he starts beating on the keys. I'm like, this dude, he was kind of quiet because didn't really get a chance to interact with him because he came in with a bunch of racket going on. So we talked a little bit. And next thing you know, man, we start hooking up, doing stuff. And, you know, cats come and cats go, man. But it's been a great, great journey with these cats, man. And we got some great music, man. And the interesting thing about me, though, man, with the whole experience of getting a record deal and doing all that stuff and touring and all that stuff, I'm doing the music for me. I'm playing the bass for me because I love to play it and I can do it. You know what I'm saying? So it's really kind of weird because I don't have that hunger to go out there, you know, and put it out and all that stuff. And I should, but I don't. You know, because the thing is, there's so much music these days. And I've got some stuff out there, man, but it's just, I just find myself making it for me.